Hey guys, little update, a bit different this time I would say, because in fact it's a kind of checklist, what I'm doing and maybe what you are doing as well before to leave on holidays, meaning all the little point to make sure that it will run smoothly, especially when you are not here. And of course, an absolute rule, this is all the shit will come when you are not here to handle them, clearly. So, what do we have? You can see a setup here. Two little webcam, and you will see how you get on the application what kind of quality of picture you can get and how I will use it. But first of all, what do you do before holidays? You do your water change. This is a two-thirds, 200 liter pro tank. It's something required. And but take care, don't do it just one day before leaving, as I used to do, just because sometimes you can disturb, for example, the filter. And if you do something wrong with the filter when you are leaving and the ecosystem of your tank is just crashing, then you will have a serious issue with the fish as well. So the idea of water change is not just to put some new element, but it's more to put away the nitrate. After that, I will try to show you directly inside because it's easier. I have on both tank such kind of nitrate absorber, okay? And you can reactivate this resin, special resin with some salt, bath. Salty bath, and it will absorb over the next weeks all the nitrate. So currently this is zero nitrate here, zero nitrate here. Fish are happy, and this is a kind of boost or a little help for the coming weeks. So water change, check what you can add, for example, for temporary nitrate absorber, typically chemistry help. If you are wondering what are the parameters, up you can see water change here plus tap water in order to avoid the crash of the pH, because typically here this is the problem and the issue that you can get with such a low mineral in the water. You can have your pH going down very quickly and burning your fish. And here, with such amount of salt, it will be quiet and stay. And another issue, you will have to fight against evaporation. So typically, you close your tank. It's a very nice way to keep all the water, but in the same time, when it's a risk, because when you have a power shutdown, then you don't have any system to maintain aeration in your tank, and typically here, Trophéus, it could be an issue. For the discus, I'm not taking the risk, and they are not splashing as much as the Trophéus, so I let open a big open here, for example, for aeration, natural aeration, if power is going down. After that, to compensate, of course, evaporation in a system where you have some overflow, like this one, enfin, both tanks have overflow, typically when you are losing water here. In fact, this is a sump. The sump behind is putting back the water missing in the tank. So you have the water level going down. And you have two tanks here. To fulfill your aquarium level when a low level is detected, and typically I put them, usually they are inside, hidden inside, and I put them outside in order to be easily fulfilled, because some people can come here times to times, for example once a week, and then they will check inside what is the water missing, and they will just use tap water. So I can already hear you, hey guys, why do you put tap water when evaporation is like osmose water, it's without mineral. So I used to put osmose water in such kind of reservoir, yes, in theory, but in fact the real implementation is a bit different. One more time, this tank could suffer of a low mineral level, because of the pH acidosis, sorry. So instead of putting back osmose water, it's easier to use tap water because you put back some mineral and you maintain a bit, you help the pH to be maintained. And here for Trophaeus, forget it, they are very happy with tap water. They don't need osmose water at all. So keep in mind, give a try, tap water, how it will be helpful for your tank, you will see. After that, in case one more time of power going down, you have here automatic, not overflow, but siphon system automatically activating himself. But if you let the tank running full power as usual, you may have an issue on this. So I don't know if you can see here properly. I would say, up, you put your pump at a very low flow. So at the end, you have easily accumulation of element in your tank. But this is the price to keep it safe. Because when the pump will, when the power will come back and the pump turn on again, the time that the siphon activates himself again, you may have an overflow of your tank because it's still a very high setup. I haven't done a lower setup just for the holidays. This is on the plan to do. After that, and another point on the checklist to not forget, this is the automatic feeder. So one more time, each tank has this duo or double from AIM feeder. You have one here, big pellet, and here this is a bit smaller element. Since it's Trophaeus, it's dedicated with a lot of spirulina, dedicated to such kind of regime, a bit special regime. Okay, and after for the discus, same feeder automat, two compartiment, and here it's even a more elaborated mixed that I named discus mixed, and you have four different food. You have wild discus, red discus, you have something for immune system, and you have something for catfish, L-catfish and catfish, I would say, for example here. You see these little guys, they have a specific food. You, of course, don't forget the secondary tank with the automatic feeder. Okay. And after that, you are ready. You check the water. You have some help to absorb the nitrate. You set up your automatic top-off of your system. And you keep in mind the food, of course. The lighting, I changed the programming of the light to slow it down. Just 2 or 3 hours, it's enough. One more time, take care when you are modifying the programmation of your lighting. If you have a tank with a lot of plant and you are shutting down the light, you will have a loss of your plant, as it will be some material in your tank, and the ecosystem or ecology of your tank will be disturbed as well. Each time that you are modifying the parameter of your automatic system, I would say it is a risk that something is not going right. So my advice would be, of course, that I'm not doing completely, I would say, try to go on holidays 1 week before to go on holidays, if you do understand what I mean. Try to don't touch or to impose you the really minimum interaction with your tank 1 week before to leave, in order to have everything smooth and to make it sure. More or less, you take a plane, you turn on the pilot turn on the engine full power before to fly during hours. If something is supposed to go wrong, it will go wrong at the beginning when you are still on the ground. This is typically the idea. After that, regarding the monitoring and the little camera that you saw, I will finish by this point. You have the little webcam, the one on the discus, as you can see, quite nice definition, and this is from Xiaomi or Mi Home monitoring webcam. something you can find online, very cheap and very good quality. You can even try to fix them, even if it's not working properly, you will see what I'm meaning. Here, this is the Trophäus, and you can see I'm just in front of the Trophäus. Yeah, it's my hand. Exactly. The nice part, if you have been checking it properly, here, this is a pH monitor. So through the webcam that you can get access anywhere online, I can get here information of pH. So you will tell me, okay, in case of acidose, what do you do? You don't have a lot of choice. If it's high risk, you call friends, family, relatives to come and to try to fix. After that, I have some camera also inside the filter. It's very important. This is a discus sump filter under the tank. And here I can control and check the wallpaper, for example, if there's an issue. I can try remotely to change the programmation, for example, if it could help to fix the issue. And here, and inside here, I can see the water level. But the nice surprise that I haven't planned, this is here on the left. I changed the heater system with an external monitoring system, and this monitoring let me see 28.9 degrees currently of the water and the target. So it's very nice. I have the pH and the temperature of the tank that I can monitor. After that, I can show you another monitoring. So it's a website that I made. This is my meaquarium.com, meaquarium.com, okay, and this is the idea to use a smart home from Xiaomi. The name is Mi Home, but for an aquarium. So my point is, you can check the temperature, of course, but you can also change the programmation. For example, here this is a discus aquarium, and if remotely I detect an issue, like it did happen already once, I can try to change, to analyze the issue and to change and to provide a fix on this. Since it is all everything on the cloud, even outside of Germany, for example, I can try to fix it. So that's all. Sorry for such a long video. I tried to structure or to not forget anything. And I guess this is an issue, or not an issue, I would say a difficulty or a myth. Everybody is thinking that fish keeping is so a hobby that will stuck you at home. But no, if you think a bit more about, and guys, here in front of you, you don't have any plant. When you have a tank with some plant, it's even easier to get a smooth ecological ecosystem in your tank, okay? So even if you don't have plant, it is always possible. Try to think, try to set up something that will last 1 week, 2 weeks, 3 weeks. In this case, you will see it will be maybe even longer. And finger crossed, it will run smoothly, especially here in this tank. I really don't want that anything happen, but this is how it is. Sometimes you have to assume, and sometimes you have to accept the risk. So that's all, guys, for today. Hope everything is going fine for you. And yeah, wish you as well, if it's possible, to go on holidays as soon as possible. Ciao, guys.